In the early stages of AFib for most patients, the condition is paroxysmal. What that means is that you're in and out of atrial fibrillation. You may have episodes that will last a few minutes and then don't come again for months until eventually they become a lot more frequent. So what is the implication? You may go to your primary care physician or your cardiologist and say that you've had heart racing spells lasting a few moments, but when you actually go to the doctor, you feel good. You feel normal. If an EKG electrocardiogram is done at that point, at that visit, they're not going to be able to diagnose atrial fibrillation. So how do you diagnose atrial fibrillation? For patients that have paroxysmal atrial fibrillation, episodes that are short-lasting, they're in and out of atrial fibrillation, frequently we use what's called patch monitors, where you put a little patch in your chest. They will monitor your heart continuously for 7 to 14 up to 28 days, and we'll be monitoring all your heartbeats night and day, and that's how we diagnose atrial fibrillation for those that have short episodes. Some patients have episodes of atrial fibrillation that are very sporadic. They may come and cause a lot of symptoms or even stroke, but not happen again for months. So sometimes if our index of suspicion is very high that you may have atrial fibrillation, particularly if your risk of stroke is elevated, we may recommend the implantation of what's called a loop recorder. Those devices sit under your skin and they may record the rhythm of your heart for up to 3 years, communicating wirelessly to either your phone or a receiver and sending daily, if there are alerts, information to your cardiologist or electrophysiologist. Today, a very common way to have atrial fibrillation diagnosed is via wearables, such as the Apple Watch, Samsung Watch. Those devices are monitoring your heart beat to beat. And if they sense that there is an irregularity in the rhythm, they may ask you to take a single lead EKG by putting your finger in the bevel. Those can actually be very accurate, and you can send that information, share with your physician, to then allow us the diagnosis without the use of a loop recorder or a patch monitor, for example. Wearables have increased the number of patients diagnosed with atrial fibrillation and earlier in the disease process significantly. Not every patient that has AFib diagnosed with a wearable needs to be treated. Most need to be monitored. And we need at that point to start lifestyle interventions to reduce the chances that you're going to progress to overt atrial fibrillation, such as weight loss, exercise, reduction of your alcohol intake, quitting tobacco use, and also screening for sleep apnea. All of those lifestyle modifications, just overall being healthier, will reduce the chances that you're going to change from asymptomatic short episodes of AFib diagnosed on your Apple Watch, for example, to overt symptomatic atrial fibrillation that requires medical therapy. So on the one hand, the watches really help us diagnose AFib earlier. Sometimes they can be false positives, and sometimes they diagnose at a period where we can still intervene with simply lifestyle modifications without the need for medications.